Public Affairs Broadcasting.
Special programming from Rockingham County Radio, rcrlive.com.
Good morning and welcome to Community Accents Radio, WLOE, WMYN Radio. My name is Sonja Parks and I'm the Assistant Superintendent for Rockingham County Schools. Can you believe we only have 60 days of school left until the end of the school year? We have started off the year on a positive note and we are going to continue this momentum and have a fabulous ending to our school year. Today I have with me Dr. O'Connor. She is the Director of Professional Education Preparation, Policy, and Accountability at the University of North Carolina at Greensboro. To give you a little bit of background information about our show today, in 2016, the UNC system selected UNCG to be one of 8 universities to open a school under the provisions of a recently passed law, House Bill 532. UNCG and Rockingham County Schools have been discussing a partnership opportunity since May of 2017. Through this partnership, we can combine the strengths of Mall Street, Rockingham County Schools, and the university to create a model school where every child receives a great education. The decision to help Mall Street is based on the resources that could be provided by RCS and UNCG working together. Mall Street did make progress this past year with several gains that we're so proud of. However, I believe with the UNCG partnership, we can do more for the students at Mall Street Elementary. So at this time, we're going to talk about some questions and learn more about the partnership. So I want to again welcome Dr. O'Connor.
Thank you so much for inviting me here today. I'm very honored to speak on behalf of UNCG about the Mall Street Partnership School. So
great.
Thank you for having me.
So excited to have her with us today. So discuss with us the community, the purposes of the partnership school.
Okay, great. So the most important purpose is to provide the students in Rockingham County and at Mall Street specifically with the best education possible. As Dr. Parks said, you know, we are wanting to build on all the success that's already happening at Mall Street to through partnership, through working together, we believe that we can do more than any of us could do working alone. So partnering with UNCG, with the Reidsville and Mall Street community, and with Rockingham County Schools, we know that we can all be better together. As Dr. Park said, the partnership school is the result of a state law that was passed in 2016, and that law puts forward 4 purposes for the schools. Improving student learning is, of course, the very first purpose. We also want to prepare pre-service teachers who are training at UNCG to work in schools like Mall Street. The partnership will not only strengthen Mall Street, but strengthen the preparation of teachers who will work across Rockingham County and in other parts of the state as well. We want to create and provide innovative professional development to support teachers who work in our schools in North Carolina. We want to make sure that we have the best teachers and that teachers are continuing to grow and learn. And we also want to conduct and disseminate research about what works for students like the students at Mall Street. So those are the 4 purposes that are put forward in the legislation, and those are the things that we'll be focusing on. But primarily, it's about making sure that the students have the best possible education through this partnership, through all of us working together.
Absolutely, and we're certainly so excited about the professional development opportunities that our teachers will receive and the opportunities that this will bring to our students. Well, talk to us a little bit about what will be different when we walk into Mall Street Elementary. What will be different and what will this be like for next school year?
Well, actually, a lot will be the same. So it's going to be the same classrooms, the same library, the same buses, the same playground. You know, it's going to feel very familiar to the children there at Mall Street. So that's important. But what will be different is the curriculum and the approach to teaching and learning. So another thing I want to talk about is that collaboration and listening are extremely important to us. We're meeting with parents, we're meeting with community leaders, we're meeting with the faith community. We want need to have input from the community about what needs to be different. So it's not just about us coming in and saying this is what we think needs to be different, but how can we all together? We meet with the Rockingham County Schools cabinet every month. So it's about all of us joining forces and joining together to decide what are some things that we can do differently to better support the children. But we will be introducing and expanding some creative and cutting-edge initiatives in the school. We'll be building on things like the Classrooms of Tomorrow that Rockingham County Schools has started with some different approaches to classroom learning environment, integrating technology, lots of hands-on learning. So students will still be learning the North Carolina Standard Course of Study. They'll still be learning to read. They'll still be learning math and science and social studies and writing and in addition to that, they'll have weekly instruction in the arts, so art, music, theater, dance, physical education. Our approach will be to integrate all of those areas into hands-on projects where children learn by doing. That's very important. We know that children learn best, and all of us really learn best by doing, so that's really important. So it'll be an active, hands-on, child-centered school environment, and that will build on children's experiences and their strengths. So I think those are, you know, really important things, active and collaborative, an active and collaborative learning environment that really focuses on the needs of children. And that's not necessarily different either. It's just that we think that we can do more of it by working together.
And so our child nutrition, our cafeterias and all of that will remain the same. We'll be working together towards that. Our busing system will remain the same. Yep. The things that we do out of our operational office will continue to be the same things that we're currently doing right now. Yeah. So, and we're excited about that.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Well, talk to us about how the partnership will be organized.
Okay. Again, it's going to feel pretty familiar to kids and to families. We're still going to have classrooms. We'll have teachers. It'll have about 420 students, very much like it has now. So there will be about 24 classrooms in grades K through 5, so the same grade levels will be served. We're planning on a few more teachers. Our projected class size is about 1 to 18. Each classroom will be led by a highly qualified, licensed teacher. So that's very important to remember. This is still going to be a school that has a very qualified, licensed teaching staff. There will also be licensed teachers in the other areas that I mentioned, like specialty areas like art, music, dance, theater, PE. We'll have a school social worker and a school counselor, UNCG student teachers and interns. All the teachers will be UNCG employees, so that will be a little bit different. The current teachers can apply to continue working at the school through this change process, and they have the option to request a transfer to another district school if they wish to continue working for Rockingham County Schools. There will be lots of UNCG faculty and students in the school supporting the teaching and learning, working with the teachers, helping the teachers to grow and learn. And all of this, of course, is to ensure the best possible education for the partnership school students. So again, a lot of it's going to feel familiar, but we do think there'll probably be more, certainly more UNCG folks in the building, but in general, maybe a few more adults than are there right now.
All right. Talk to us about why this is a great opportunity for students and educators of the partnership school.
Well, we feel like this is an opportunity for us to bring the best of what all of the different partners have to offer together to benefit the children. So we have the resources and knowledge that we have at UNCG, through the School of Education, through the College of Visual and Performing Arts, the School of Health and Human Sciences, and really across the whole university. Students across our university may be interested in service learning opportunities and opportunities to learn from and with the Reidsville community, the Rockingham County community, and all of it, you know, that again, that collaboration to ensure the best education for the children. UNCG is all about access and opportunity. That's a core part of who we are and what we believe at UNCG. And so this is an opportunity for us to really collaborate with the community, a nearby community, but that is has different resources and different contexts than we have in Greensboro. And it's an opportunity for us to invest in the future of our state through education. Mm-hmm. Partnership School also provides a unique opportunity for our UNCG students, faculty, and staff to learn from and with the Rockingham County community. Mm-hmm. So we're very excited about the opportunity for all of us to become better together.
Let's talk about some of the events and some of the things that we've done in the past few months together. Just some of the events. You know, we've been hosting lots of parent and community events at different locations, either at Mall Street or in area churches, and just some different opportunities that we've been offering to our students and parents.
Yeah. So, back in October, we had October, we had several meetings with the community at at the school.
Mm-hmm.
We had one at Zion Baptist Church.
Yes.
Lots of opportunities for us to talk, to begin that conversation with the community, to talk with folks, hear about, what their questions and concerns were. And so we got a lot of feedback early on from the community, and we've used that to help us to make sure that as we're planning, we're taking into account the needs of the community. We've done a lot of just relationship building between UNCG and Rockingham County Schools, between UNCG and the Moss Street faculty and staff and the Moss Street community. Moss Street faculty and staff have just been so welcoming to UNCG. We just feel really welcome, and folks there have been so generous with their time and with resources. They've invited us to participate in events that they have. So in October, there was a spooktacular math and science night. It was so much fun. The kids came in their costumes, and they got to go from station to station, doing different math and science activities and getting some treats along the way. And so we were there. We brought our a wind table, which is an opportunity for kids to experiment with air current. And so they got to take junk and make different objects to see what would fly. And we had some really successful flying objects. Some of those things went really high up in the gym. So that was really fun. And instead of candy, we gave away a lot of UNCG stuff. We had Spiro masks. So Spiro is our mascot, Spiro the Spartan. And so we had masks, and we had bubbles and Mardi Gras beads and blue and gold and crayons and coloring books. So that was really fun to get that opportunity to start to interact. And then in December, again, Moss Street invited us to be part of their December literacy night and their winter program. And so I guess I've got a theme here going with fun and messy activities, right? So, because there was yarn and stuff all over the gym floor, we had to clean up after ourselves after the wind table. But so then in December we came and we did an activity making oobleck. So kids got to read recipes. Oobleck is a Dr. Seuss thing, if you don't know what it is, and it's kind of like slime.
Mm-hmm.
And so kids got to read a recipe at their reading level and make oobleck out of cornstarch and water and food coloring. And so that was really fun. And we were all covered in head to toe in cornstarch. Again, we had to clean up after ourselves. So that's been, we've had some opportunities like that to really start to make friends and interact. We have UNCG's provided a new teacher support coach who's working with the beginning teachers at Moss Street this year. We've had some collaboration between some of the current Moss Street faculty and some of the UNCG faculty are planning some activities together this semester. We had some of our UNCG instructional coaches came and did lessons with the kids in the STEM lab. So all of the children at Moss Street came through and had an opportunity, and the teachers too, to experience some of the hands-on learning that we were talking about earlier.
Mm-hmm.
The teachers, coaches did lessons in kindergarten and first grade. They did a literacy lesson with the three little pigs, and the kids collaborated in teams to build houses out of junk that would withstand the big bad wolf. And we had the big bad wolf come, and he huffed and he puffed, and most of the houses stood. So the kids did a really great job. What else? We did Second and third graders did a lesson on force and motion using matchbox cars. So they got to race cars and see, you know, how they could make the cars go faster using principles of force and motion. And then the fourth and fifth graders did a literacy lesson involving Legos. So they got to predict the ending of a story and build that using Legos. And so, this is an opportunity for the kids to kind of see what it, you know, what it might be like to be a student at Mount Street Partnership School next year, and for the teachers to see, you know, some of the things about the teaching and learning environment, so that they, you know, that they could have a really good idea about what it's going to be like to teach at Mount Street, in the Mount Street Partnership School. So it's been fun. We're planning lots more activities over the next few weeks to, you know, help the community get to know us and for us to get to know them. We're going to be at the health and wellness night that the school is hosting on March 15th. We're planning a science festival where we'll have a lot of hands-on science activities again. We're planning an arts event. And then we're going to be out in the community as well, at the churches, at, you know, parks, at the different community events, to reach out to parents and give information and give folks an opportunity to enroll. So we're really excited about going forward and continuing to build the relationships and get to know each other. I think it's really important that, you know, we bring closer together the UNCG community with the Reidsville Mount Street community.
So it's just so exciting to hear all the collaboration that we have been doing together over the past few months and all the different activities and resources that we have been able to provide to our students. And we are super excited about the events that that we have that's scheduled for the upcoming months. And I just want to thank UNCG for all of the opportunities and reaching out to our community and getting to know the folks at Mall Street. It's been great. And we certainly appreciate that. At this time, we're going to go to a break, and we will resume in just a few moments.
WLOE Eden.
WMYN Mayodan.
Listen online all the time.
RockinghamCountyRadio.com.
Welcome back to WLOE WMYN Radio. At this time, we're going to talk with UNCG, Dr. O'Connor, about some of the events and things that we're scheduling with the community.
Yeah, we've been, as I was saying before the break, it's really important for us to build the relationships with the community, to allow the community the opportunity to get to know UNCG, and for us to get to know the strengths and the all of the wonderful things that are happening in the community. So we've done a few things as well to help, you know, the adults get to know each other as well. And so we had a mix and mingle event at Moss Street for the Moss Street teachers, and we brought UNCG faculty and staff up to Moss Street. Had a really nice reception. People were able to, you know, have something to eat and drink and talk to one another, get to know each other, ask questions. We also invited Rockingham County teachers, Moss Street teachers, and other Rockingham County teachers down to UNCG last week for another mix and mingle event in our Teaching Resources Center. And people might not know that all the teachers in the Piedmont Triad area have privileges to check out materials from our Teaching Resources Center. And so we have the sign-up forms for that there at the event. We also want teachers to know about the, you know, different continuing education opportunities that are available at UNCG. So we had faculty there to talk about graduate programs or additional licensure programs that teachers might be able to earn. One of the benefits of working for UNCG is that employees at UNCG do get to take courses. We have some tuition assistance on that. So if you work for UNCG, then you can take courses. And so we hope that the Moss Street teachers at the partnership school will take advantage of that opportunity to advance their education. So we've done those things. We've also been meeting with a group we're calling the Community Council, and these are just folks who are interested in being a part of planning and giving us some feedback. And so it's a mix of community leaders, parents, faith leaders, Just folks who have a vested interest. A lot of the folks that we had a meeting last night, actually, a lot of the folks at the table were, I went to Moss Street. You know, it's a school that has a lot of history and deep roots in the community. Absolutely. And we just feel like that's such a great learning opportunity for us and for our students to see what it's like to work and teach in a community that has such a long, you know, important history and all of the strengths that go along with that being a community-based school. And so we've really been working with the community council to listen, to hear what the questions are, what are concerns, what are things that are currently happening at Moss Street that are really strong that we need to make sure that we continue. Mm-hmm. What are some of the things that they would like to see improve or strengthen? Mm-hmm. You know, what are ways that we can better reach out and engage families in the school? So these are conversations that we've been having with the community council. Also, the other night, Dr. Jewel Cooper, who's our associate dean for academic affairs and student services, and I were able to meet with the Ministerial Association in Reidsville to reach out to the faith leaders and you know, give them an opportunity to hear from us and for us to learn again from them about what the best ways might be for us to engage with their communities and to learn from them. So I think, you know, I said to the ministers the other night and pastors, we don't want to be strangers. We want, you know, the communities to really get to know one another and to really learn from and with each other. So another event that's going on is at UNCG every spring, we have a huge event called Science Everywhere. This year it's on April 21st, and actually if you look on the UNCG website and just search in our search box Science Everywhere, and you'll be able to see some video from previous Science Everywhere. It's amazing. Thousands and thousands of, you know, kids and families come to campus. We have all kinds of activities going on, and we're actually going to provide buses and invite the Moss Street community to come to Science Everywhere. It's on a Saturday. It's a family activity. So not really a field trip, but more of a, you mm-hmm. know, a family mm-hmm. event. Mm-hmm. And invite folks to come down to UNCG to be part of that event. We think that it's another way to really bring the communities closer and to invite the Moss Street community into the UNCG community, just as the UNCG has been invited into Moss Street. And we're, you know, just so honored to be a part of Moss Street going forward.
We just want to thank UNCG for reaching out to our communities, forming the community council, and just spending time getting to know the folks in the Moss Street community. Talk with the viewers and our listeners today about the registration process and future timelines.
Great, thank you. So after the final Board of Education vote on the Memorandum of Understanding, that's a document that's going to govern the operation of the school because it is a partnership between UNCG and Rockingham County Schools. We need that final authorization to get everything started, and that's going to happen tomorrow night. So after that, we'll begin having meetings and events to enroll students, some of the things that I was just talking about. It's important to note that current Moss Street students will need to enroll in order to return next year. This is a school of choice, and so parents have to choose for their children to attend. It's a really simple enrollment form, mm-hmm. one page. On that one page form, a family can enroll all of their children with one form. So for example, if a family has a rising fourth grader, a rising second grader, and a rising kindergartner currently at Moss Street, they can just put all three children's names on one form and they'll all be enrolled. That form will give us permission to share information or receive information from Rockingham County Schools so that we can just transfer records and make it easier on families. So once enrolled, children will remain enrolled until they complete elementary school or until their family were, if you were to move away or decide that you wanted to enroll elsewhere. Mm-hmm. So you only have to enroll once. Students are eligible based on the school that they currently attend. So all of the current Moss Street students are eligible to attend the partnership school. But any student who is currently attends a low-performing school or who has struggled and is low performing themselves could be eligible to attend as well. Kindergarten registration is coming up. We know people will be ready to sign up their kindergartners. So for the 2018-19, the upcoming year, students who live within the Moss Street Elementary School attendance zone And siblings of current Moss Street students are eligible to come in as kindergartners. And you'll have to do the kindergarten registration process and then also sign up on that enrollment form that we were just talking about.
So again, special call meeting tomorrow night on March 1st at our administrative office board meeting. It's at 6 o'clock p.m. This will be an action item for our memorandum of agreement and our lease between Rockingham County Schools and UNCG. So that meeting will be tomorrow night at 6 o'clock p.m. And just to end our show this evening, or this morning, excuse me, this morning, I'm going to end with our mission and our commitments and goals. Working together, the university and Rockingham County Schools can create and implement a transformative, high-quality educational program that stimulates growth, builds students' confidence and hope, and models exemplary professional practice. And that's exactly what that we have set out to do with this partnership.
We're so excited to be a part of it. Remember that we are all better together.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for joining our show.